Come on. Damn. What's good, America? Welcome back to the channel. It's your man, Nostalgic Noir. I'm bringing you another episode of this Fight Night Champion, man. Make sure to hit that like button. Make sure to subscribe, become a homie. Special shout out to the homies, man. Definitely subscribe, become a homie, and join the family. And yeah, man. What's good with y'all? I hope y'all doing all right. Hope you living all right. Hope your mama all right and everybody else, man. Yes, indeed. We did lose episodes, so we have a 17-0 record. I think we lost about three fights worth of film. So last time we left off, I don't think anybody... Yeah, y'all didn't get to see the Joe Fox fight, which sucks. Y'all did... last thing I dropped was the Nico Jones fight, and we beat him. That's what y'all saw when we went down. Then we fought Oren Prescott. We whooped him in round two. That was FNF, so... Then we had Butterbean. That was a pretty good one. The Butterbean episode. I can't believe I lost that. Hopefully I can fight him again before he retire. Maybe we'll just have to do it again on a different fighter. We got the, what is this? Tommy Morrison. We fought Tommy Morrison again. Knocked him out in the first round again. Tommy just washed. Joe Fox knocked him out in the first round. He was washed. And Lucas Ben, he took us three rounds. And we also got sponsored by multiple different things. Now we're getting sponsored by Reebok. So yeah, we're gonna take this deal for Reebok. Short notice fight. Let me see. I really don't want to fight him, to be real. He 0-3. It's really a tune-up fight. We go see if we got any better options. Try to get a couple fights in this video. I don't want to make it short. Oh yes, why would we fight him? Look, we could fight George Foreman. We taking that George Foreman fight. Not only could we fight George Foreman, we could fight Vidlali. I can't pronounce that shit, bro, but he's 6'8". God damn. Where we gonna fight? I forgot where we be fighting in this. His name is Detroit. Is it Detroit? Let's assume it's Detroit. Living in America. The award ceremony. Let's see if we won anything this year. Prospect of the year. There we go. 17-0. Top rank. 8. Lennox Lewis. He under us. Defensive player of the year. Comeback of the year. Upset of the year. Oh, yeah. That's a good fight we picked then. Knockout of the year. We ain't got knockout of the year. That's crazy. Bro, to get these fights, you have to extend. Like, the fight got to, like, let's say if you want fighter of the year, it's definitely something that has to go the distance. Which is pretty good if you get a lot of fighter of the years. But, yeah, we got to start pushing people to the distance. It will do damage to us if they do too much damage to us. Well, we can't fight fucking Butterbean again. Because he just retired at 48. That sucks. Like I said, we just got to do it on a different fighter. Eddie Chambers. Well, I'm glad nobody in... Dang, I knew we should have took that fight. Both of them retired. 43-38. I got to start adjusting this, bro. I got to start making the older people lower. That's what we got to do next time. That's going to help us. It's like, it takes us forever to reach these guys. And then they're like 38 and they're retired. First off, him retired at 38 is sad. Feel like he got a little bit more in the trunk, but we lost some heavy hitters in that. That's cool. Easier way to the championship. I do plan on playing multiple characters, so y'all don't be worried. Doing multiple weight classes, but first head, I'm gonna do this training, and then I'm gonna be back, man. So I just got out of training, man, and that didn't feel right. Not even okay. It just didn't feel smooth. No. Oh, that's our last week, so we gotta rest. Ah, shit. Well, hopefully we got enough points. Yeah, my jabs feel really slow. That's one thing. They feel off. Jabs suck. Funny thing is, I've been knocking people out with low jab. I really don't know what's up, Greg. Nah, I gotta get them jabs up there. We're not accurate, and that's mainly the problem. That's all I can upgrade. One? I was about to say, why just one? We didn't earn nothing. get our heart up, or should we have picked combinations? That's probably what's hurting us. We can't string together no combination. Alright, I guess this will be the episode we debuted our new gear, so I'll see y'all in the fight.
Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to Chicago.
Oh, we in the ballroom. Shout out Chicago. Oh, look at that Adidas sponsorship. Multiple different things. Now we're getting sponsored by Reebok. They rebranded your boy. Damn. 81-9. 72 of them boys went down. Obviously, that's the game. It's not the real record. I'm sure he has like extra fights and losses added in there. Or maybe he ain't lost a fight this whole time we've been simulating. But he definitely been in some matches. Oh, yeah, I ain't taking no hits from Foreman. I'm sorry. What's up, homie? Oh, I learned. Y'all missed them other fights, but we was in tough situations. People hit way harder. Come on, old Foreman.
Can the shorter fighter in a matchup like this be effective with a power?
Look at Foreman. Zombie walking. Dog walking Foreman. He's so slow. Oh, I was about to say, a lot of people cut us off by now. Shit.
Because now, usually the taller guy, he's punching down. And when you punch down, you leave an opening.
Come on. Damn. Come on.
He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by George Foreman. He had his eyes set on the uppercut, but was unable to land it.
Come on. Come on, Foreman. You with the Wolves now, Foreman. He tried to push me off. Hey, he taking him. We got to fall back. He keep trying to trap me in his corner. That's going to be a problem.
Oh, and he returns fire with a left hand. Last 10 seconds of this first round.
Caught him.
Dollar Bill's probably sitting back right now saying, hey, I got everything figured out. Coming off of a sensational round you just saw, he was able to do some serious damage to his opponent.
We just got to burn the clock so we can start pushing these boys in some farther and deeper into the round. That'll do better for our popularity. Make us more money also. And then we'll have a higher chance of getting fighter of the year. We just can't get hit that much though, so we got to be ducking. We got to run, pretty much. You can't sit and take punches, even in block. I learned that with other characters. No matter how high your block is, you just can't sit and block. Unless you're trapped in the corner, but you still got to push them off you. Or wait till they stamina low, like that. And then our hooks are so high, if I throw a hook, it's like he just catches him. Unless I'm too far. Ooh, come on. I'ma just dance with him. This our new method, by the way. Our new game plan. Definitely with these fat mofos and slow ones like Tommy Morrison.
Blocks that belt line well.
Damn.
He's committed to that left hand and it's working out.
Knew I was gonna catch him one time. Damn. Walk up on him. Damn.
Job of just being patient now and looking for that one good shot.
Well, you know, the landscape of this business, the history of this business is littered with guys.
What is going on?
Had someone hurt, they get a little careless, they get caught. He better watch out that he doesn't get put on that landscape.
Many would ask themselves,
come on, Foreman.
I have withstanded that. The answer is probably no, but for big George Foreman, it's a strong yes.
Caught you. Damn. We just got to sneak in there and catch him a couple times. Come on. Embarrassing him. Sorry, George Foreman. George cut. George cut, man. We put. Hey, I knew George was getting cut. Hey, if we didn't cut George, I would have had to go check the settings. I ain't hitting him that hard. Like, not with, like no shattering hooks. I'm going to start throwing strong ones in there when he get really tired. But they could very well clear up his cut, no doubt. Definitely if I don't hit him that much. Damn. Not the fighter that was clearly dazed in the last round. I love, bro. Look, bro. Dude, a savage. Look at him. Dollar bills and doing a thing. He's just standing there. What in the world is he doing? Well, what he's doing is he's. You got my camera turned a different way. I see. I don't know what to do. Get back. Stay over there. You wild animal. Mother beast. This is a bear versus a bear versus a goddamn. Well, nah, I'm pretty. Apollo pretty big as damn, so. Dollar bill so dangerous with that accuracy. A two punch combination landing. Ooh, hey, we dipped part of that punch if you didn't see it.
Bruh.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. It's that Mayweather style. Fine work with a double jab downstairs. Damn, he caught me with that one. I'm too close. Come on. Come on. Hey, I'm walking him this round. Hey, this round he ghosted. I'm sorry. We ain't knocked him one time. That's cool. But we ghosted him. That definitely helped his cut, though. Because he recovered 8% of his shit. So, by the way, if you lost, when the bar is filled, the higher the percentage on the damage, the more damage that's been done. So, anytime anybody get cut, that bar goes incredibly high. But it really just means damage, like, as far as, like, visual, like, you know, your cuts and shit. Because when you swell, when they face be swollen, it don't be that, damage don't be that high. And most people only swell when they're the younger fighters. I checked. Or the more fights you have, the higher chance you're going to get cut. Damn. I don't know what the hell happened right there. Come on. Keep up. Well, his opponent is opening up and coming keep forward, up. So I would think there are some opportunities that exist. Yeah, I think some counterpunching keep opportunities. Up. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end. Keep up. Keep moving. Hey, this is a ghost fight. Damn. When he does catch me, he catches me. He ain't got no stamina. And this is, hey, him holding me is hurting him. I ain't even know that was a thing. Come back. Come back. Hey, once I saw that damage, or whatever was so damn low, I knew he couldn't take nothing. I should have aimed for his face, made his cut worse, but I got respect for Foreman. Damn, he got back up. Never mind. Damn. Come on. Damn. I don't want to get cut. We can still get cut.
Fourth round now with its last 10 seconds.
Caught him.
George Foreman's inability to get away from his opponent's right hand is costing
him. Yep. Hey, now that I know how to, hey, once I figured out what hand the coach starts swinging the most, that's when his cut really gonna be in trouble. Hey, I know his right hand every time to that right side of the face. He ain't gonna be able to see. It ain't gonna sleep him though. We ain't gonna be able to sleep him without overall hitting him everywhere. I'm sorry. Cause he'll just keep covering that up. It's not easy. It's not easy now. I'm just good at running away. Except, I don't know. Some fighters, I cannot escape the punches. Lennox Lewis was one of those fighters sometimes where I couldn't escape his punches. He just corners me every time. Mike Tyson, because when they hit you, it just does too much damage.
He's also got to pitch something at his opponent, chuck something at his opponent to keep him off a little bit, too.
Come on. That's an exchange. Let's exchange. Come on, that's an exchange. Set that up. Bow, hit his ass again, just to make sure he don't get back up after that. Too old. You out your damn.
Get on your bicycle when you've been hurt. No, the bicycle's not there. You got flat tires. What you gotta do is
that boy said the bicycle not there. You got flat tires. On his ass. Damn. Come on, that's not the one you want it for. That's not the one you want it for. Woo! That's not the one he wanted. Damn, his face done went into his arm. Big buff ass. That's a country big. Don't get up again. Yo, this dude's an Iron Man. My thing is, they don't stop swinging. Shit, nope. We're going to walk you out for the rest of the round. That's cool.
And now he's targeting upstairs.
Yep.
Wow, look at that. Trading shots. Trying to go downstairs, but off target.
Come on. Come on. Set him up since he won't let me make it. Come on. Extra.
And that's the end of round five. Foreman, well, he's back in the corner, which is critical in terms of trying to stop the bleeding on that cut.
No. That cut ain't going nowhere.
The new defensive game plan.
Yeah, they have to make sure that they buy some time here and start moving their head, using their
damn
legs, tying up a little bit.
Foreman, just stay down. We done knocked him down like three times at this point. You just keep getting back up. Tommy didn't get up this much. Nor did he bleed. I don't think he bled. Did he bleed? I think we bled Tommy. Not the second time. He also still hits hard.
Clearly, he wants to keep things in the same order.
Well, part of the testing of anybody being successful at anything in boxing,
they cheering for Foreman? Oh yeah, I gotta walk you out. This is beef. How is he cornering me now?
Does he get carried away with himself? You know, does he get a little cocky?
I was about to say, I'm like trying to move him out of his, trying to drain him. He's all stamina, and this dude's, come on.
Bruh.
That's called the exchange. His movement is good, too, now. Come on. Come on. Damn. Boom. Damn, I tried to hit him one more time. I'm talking about I reached in for that shit. That was a power punch, by the way, people. Yo, this dude is an Iron Man. He will not go. Yo, he ain't going down. Which is only going to make him fight more aggressive. Because, of course, he's not going to win the card with all these knockdowns. Without knocking me down at least six times. Come on, Foreman. I'm trying to get Fighter of the Year, bruh. And you definitely. Hey, can I see them combinations again? Can we get the combinations again? They're playing with me. Ooh. Like, he threw one out. Oh. Hey, y'all. Hey. Oh, y'all see the duck? Hey, stop playing with me. Stop playing with me. I can play this. I can play this against the computer. He ain't getting up. Like, they didn't even let him fall. They just called it. But I wanted to fight that 6'8 dude. Picture trying to swing at his head. That's a great way to start out the video, man. This dude threw 403 total. He swung 403 times. And he only hit me 96 times. That's a goddamn shame. I was 51%. Bro, that combination, y'all can't lie, that combination was sick. If you don't think that combination was sick, you just a hater. I ducked his punch. He took two in the stomach, threw a wild hook, ducked that shit, and he took an uppercut. That was the dopest shit I've seen. And then he was bleeding. He was bloody. He was a bloody mess. I hate to do Foreman. We ain't fighting Foreman no more. He don't deserve that. He is a national treasure who needs to be protected. I take that back. We did lose at least one fight. And I redid it. Because I felt like he was cheese. But that was in the beginning. Like, we had, like, what, 6-7 fights under our belt? I think it was our 7th fight. We got, like, he knocked us out, and it didn't even give us a chance. It was doing the whole get-up animation, rock back and forth, but I ain't never got hit and not got a chance to get back up in this game. So I feel like that was cheese. But I see y'all towards when we leveling up, putting the match attributes in, and then I'll see y'all at the match also. It's interesting. They made me do a sparring match with George Foreman. And I forgot the other dude's name. But I sadly had to knock Foreman out a couple more times. Sadly. I ain't want to do it to my man. Yeah, I like that. Our uppercuts probably is like putty. But when you got people blocking your heaviest punches, they kind of going to have trouble with your other ones. But I'll see y'all at the fight, man. Oh. Hey, this is the big show. Alongside my partner Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. So glad you're with us as we welcome you to the New York Arena in mid. Oh, look at us. Hey, we finally made it. This is the big show. Big shout out New York. Hey, we sponsored by Reebok, by the way. Adidas obviously didn't love us like that.
Bruh.
With new company comes rebranding. Damn, hey, Sonny Liston got that gold popping, though. I'm not even going to cap. That gold look lit. Hey, we still, all right, hey, my unit still go harder than his. I'm sorry. He got some crackhead eyes. I'm not going to lie, though. Definitely towards the end. Yeah, Sonny Liston, he got some. He got the power behind them punches. Treat him with caution.
Obey my commands at all times. Let's have a good, clean fight. Touch him up.
I mean, one hit from Sonny could be the end of our fight.
Opening round scheduled for 10.
Come on, Sonny, show me what you got, bro. Did a little damage. Hey, we doing damage off our punches now.
Talking about how the national anthem is usually longer than his fights.
That's a well scored left hand
Fuck.
By Dollar Bill.
His punch did more damage. I measured it with our hook. That when he threw that hook and I caught him and he caught me back, I looked down and it's like he didn't even lose health.
People in the seats early on, that's what they expect to see here.
And early on, sometimes too much of a good thing, guess what? It can be dangerous, it can backfire. He lands a punch and it doesn't get rid of the guy. Well, what else can he do? What happens then?
Boy, Sonny Liston now doing good damage to the midsection. And this
Come
is
on.
The kind of Sonny Liston that dismissed Floyd Patterson in back-to-back title.
Bro, I'm putting everything. Hey, I'm throwing power punches. I'm mixing it up. He trying to get me in this corner. I don't got time for it, bro.
He's an honorary guy, just a mean guy, and he's a strong guy. He knows how to fight. He knows how to go upstairs, downstairs. He knows how to put punches together. Technically as sound as he is.
Come on. Hey, first round, we're going to tell. Hey, body is going to be broken.
Nice block by Dollar Bill.
He does go. He moves quick. See, he moves way faster. Foreman wish he, had that, look at that. He get himself, he put himself in this.
Missed the body shot. A well-targeted hook to the head by Dollar Bill. A striking combination by Dollar Bill.
Come on, fade. Took a lot of that stamina just aiming for his body. So that's going to, that's helped shorten the fight already right there. I just know his damage was a little bit too much. He only had to recover 3%. I recovered 4%. And look how many times we were hitting him.
Here we go. Round two is underway.
The reason I knocked these boys out so nice, man, I know the system. He ain't had no health. Ain't had no stamina. Ain't had no health. Hey, it's about to be a long round for him if he get up. Not on the Jordan logo. Not on the Jumpman logo. He jumped up kind of fast. Listen, throw nothing but power punches. That's one reason why he was doing more damage. Missing normal punches don't take that much stamina, by the way, fellas. Y'all never played this before. Damn.
Make the referee come in between you and break you.
Good defense upstairs to stay away from that offensive assault. Good shot to the head with that right hand. We're seeing a lot of work.
Come on. Come on. Hey, he went blow for blow and he just ain't have it in him. He went blow for blow and he just did not have it in him. I'm sorry. Hey, we were throwing bombs at each other. Boy, that boy felt like he done got shot in the back or something. Sonny, make it easy for us. Just don't get back up. And he beat it at 9. I know where you bleeding at too. Come on. Oh! Hey, that's the signature Roy Jones punch, by the way, if y'all didn't know. That is like the whole duck and bob. Like that was the whole set. That's why he fell so quick. I don't even know how I did that. That shit is dope though. He threw that one. Hey, the body punch slipped off me. Didn't even catch me. Dude. Yo, Sonny Liston falls are the funniest out of everybody, bro. Get out of here. Get out of here, Sonny. We busting boys up now. You fight me, you walking out with blood on your face now. Bloodshot eyes and all. Help your mans up. Hey, this was the best fight we had. I'm not gonna lie. I ain't never did shit like what we did in these last two fights. Them the best knockouts. As far as like knockouts, these are my best knockouts. We threw more punches, but we hit a lot. We hit a lot of them. 64%. He had a counter. We had no counters. Probably why he did so much damage that one. That was probably a counter, what he caught me with. We should be getting a title fight now. Uh-oh, look at this. Nike wants to sponsor you. Hey, just got a sponsorship offer. Won't lie. Y'all always say it's not a lot. Let's go ahead and take Nike. Hey, we set. It's all on us. Nike'd up. You gotta fight. I gotta fight Tyson. I'm sorry. You gotta fight Tyson. Hold on. Before we do that, who's champion? Because you were just champion. Who are these? Are these real fighters or just made up? Because it looked like they whooped everybody. Rick Fox, number one contender. Yeah, we just go ahead and skip over everybody and take that fight right there. That being said, man, thank y'all for watching. I hope you enjoyed the series. I hope you've been enjoying this Fight Night Champion series in general. Hope to see you again at the next episode. Make sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, become a homie, join the family. Thank you for all the homies who stuck here with me. And man, I hope to see you again. Till next time, man.